Welcome, everybody. Back on again, and this time around it's going to be Divinity Original Sin. But I'm only going to be on for probably about an hour, hour and a half. Reason being is it's, we're getting snowed in right now over here where I live. So I'm going to have to get everything done early, because I have to leave for work early to allow myself some time to, you know, like, maybe clear out a snowbank in front of my driveway or something when the plows come through. It's like they plow the streets, but they fuck me over in the process.
Excuse me.
Yeah, they clear out all the snow, but then they just put it all right in front of my driveway. Like, thanks, guys. I like being kissed before being fucked, guys. So, but anyway, I'm here, and it's all good at the moment. And I better get these crummy things on. And also throughout part of the stream, gonna have me some butter beans. And one or two of these V8 energy drinks. And yes, I'll be using mods, but the only mod I'm using is the sprint buff. Which I prefer to do, just go it alone.
An elf sits tucked away in a dark spot, lazily rolling dice onto the surface of a barrel. They sound like the dry cackling of an old witch.
Snake eyes.
She chuckles.
I bet that's just what they'll look like. Rolling dice? Deciding fates. Don't worry, honey. It isn't yours.
She looks you up.
I think my last game, I ended up fighting her, and ended up killing her too.
Never say never, though.
She eyes you quite seriously.
Not the future, no. But I can read the past in flesh. One of the perks of being an elf, you see.
Oh yeah, and that's something different. That's something different in this game. They don't do in any other. Elves in this game are cannibals. Like, they'll eat their own. Or they'll eat the flesh of humans and stuff.
I could lick your arm and tell you how you spent the night before last. Shall I?
She gives your arm a vigorous stroke of the tongue, efficient, like a cat grooming.
You were in a cellar with other sorcerers. As everyone lay sleeping, you lay awake thinking of someone back home. A very special someone. You were reminiscing about the things you used to do together. Of course it is. The truth's right there, skin deep. But don't you worry, darling. Your secret's safe with me. I don't lick.
As soon as the Inquisitor gets here, we'll have you drive over the side of the ship with him. Oh, Magisters. Guy right there.
I don't care about us. We're like cattle to them.
I'll give you that knuckle if you keep carrying on.
One of us will take our own. They're picking us off one by one.
We just skipped to the part where I reassure you and you shut up.
Cancel.
I'm busy watching for clues, sorcerer. Go take your sob story somewhere else.
A scruffy man lounges against the wall with scarred arms folded. A sly smile playing on his face, he stares across at the Magister guarding him. Noticing you, he straightens and beckons for you to come closer.
Watch your back, new fish. There's a murderer on board, and I'd bet 3 months' pay is this tramp Ifan.
Rolling his eyes at the Magister's warning, the man named Ifan beckons again.
No.
He leans in and adjusts your collar with a sharp tug, balancing its weight so it no longer presses on...
Inches less that way, right?
Hocking a phlegmy gobbet in your general direction, the sullen Magister settles back to his task of glowering at Ifan. And now, you.
We used to know each other, more's the pity. I was his commander many, many, many moons ago. Isn't that right, Vic?
Standing far back from Ifan, the tight-faced Magister draws one finger across his throat in an elaborate fashion, but says nothing. Ifan grins, flashing pointed white teeth.
Same as he was at 14 years old. Only difference is somebody gave him a bigger sword, and now he's Johnny Big Pants.
Johnny Big Pants.
Long story. Maybe I'll tell you about it in the joy. Away from interested parties. No. The dead man, Finn, is it? I'd no business with him. And I wouldn't put a man down without good reason.
He glances over at Magister Victor, who's staring back at him with pointed intensity.
Damn shame sheer annoyance isn't reason enough. The joy, I've heard a lot. Nothing good. No surprise there, since Bishop Alexander runs the show. Wonder if we'll get to meet the Ringmaster himself. Not eager to bow before the great Bishop Alexander, son of the divine himself. My sentiments exactly. But Vic here will blow a blood vessel if he hears you talking like that.
What are you conspiring about over there? You? What's your name?
Oh, don't mind him. Vic's just got a bee in his bonnet. And that bee is me.
Name?
Magister Victor looks at you suspiciously, then scrawls something illegible down in a tiny notebook. He scowls at you as he stows the notebook back in his voluminous robes.
Away with you, at once.
Ifan performs an elaborate pantomime of keeping quiet, one finger in front of his lips as he leans back against the wall.
Damn. I want to pick his pocket. Oh, hi, White. Well, it's got permadeath. I like it. And it's the kind that, when you die, your save file is... it's deleted immediately. So, that's my kind of hardcore right there. Not like most other games where when you die, they give you, like, upgrade points and gold, achievement points, etc., etc. This one here, when you die, it truly is all over. So, yeah, I'm starting over at the beginning of the game.
Can we just skip to the part where I reassure you and you shut up?
You think me mad?
Mad? Insufferable, surely.
What have you done in here anyway?
I'll tell you if you can keep it quiet long enough for me to listen.
I spent my life singing for my slaves to bring me my supper. Finer fare than boiled roots and rotten tubers.
I think we need to adjust the camera here a little bit. It's like our head's been cut off.
Meanwhile, the Magisters feast on honeyed meat behind this very wall. The indignity.
Mad? Insufferable, surely.
Yeah, I won't be able to steal anything.
Seems to me you should be a little more afraid. There's a killer about, after all.
Till overboiling a bit of cabbage becomes a crime, I shall hold my head steady.
What have we here? A fresh face in this stale hell. Let's size you up, shall we? See if you'll do.
And again, I said this last time. Lizards shouldn't even be sounding like this. They should be sounding more like this. Kinda like what Killer Croc sounds like. In Batman Arkham Asylum.
The lizard looks you up and down, like a farmer would a fetching horse. All of a sudden, he grips you firmly by the chin, with the intent of inspecting your teeth.
There's some discoloration, but I've seen worse. After all, one can't expect to find prime merchandise on a squalid little ship like this. Now then, to business. You will answer me three questions. The first one is this. Can you cook? Oh, goodness, no. Don't even mention the demon's testes that are turnips. On to the second question. Can you knit, weave? In short, tailor? Yes, I can tell from your vagabond chic, a bag is as good as a shirt kind of style. I shouldn't be getting my hopes up.
Oh, yes, and I'm quite impressed with the Giorgio Armani suit you got there, buddy.
On then to my final query. Have you the ability to administer the upkeep of one's personal appearance? The delicate art of cosmetics, just as I thought. That explains what's besieging my nostrils.
Yippers.
So, three questions asked, three questions answered. Let's evaluate, shall we? As per your own testimony, you have the taste buds of a dung beetle, the fashion sense of a monkey in a clown suit, and your personal hygiene reminds one of a carcass rotting in the sun. That won't do at all, see? I'm sad to say I must deny you the opportunity to be my slave. Ever so sorry. I know, but you just don't have what it takes. A good slave's made of stone stuff, I'm afraid. Still, hone your skills, and one day you may just qualify for a position in a lesser household than mine. You keep dreaming, you hear?
It was one of them. I know it.
Would you put a knuckle in it? I'm trying to concentrate.
They don't care about us. We're like cattle to them.
I'll give you that knuckle if you keep carrying on.
One of us will get our own.
Oh, hey, mine. Yep, gotta start over. This game's got the good kind of permadeath. The kind where it deletes your save file after you die. Exactly what happened yesterday. I'll be able to pick any pockets here.
There has been a murder, Your Majesty.
Talk to everybody.
It's a register, sir. Good, good. Magister Williams is just about done with the last passenger.
And I think I might have messed up. It's gonna go right into the front of the ship.
You faring okay so far? Glad to hear it.
Oh, and I just quick saved. But yeah, I think after talking to him, you get taken to the front of the ship, and then the cutscene ensues, and you're on the island. So.
One of us will get our own.
So it looks like I have to disconnect my controller in order to reconnect my controller.
The elf is reading a volume of Cranley Hubert's famous encyclopedia. He looks up, his big round eyes scanning your body, absorbing every detail. He reaches out and takes your hand, turning it this way and that, examining it from every angle. Finally, he pinches your skin, gently tugging at it.
Fascinating.
He sits back and returns to his book, flicking quickly from page to page, completely oblivious to your presence.
It is simultaneously too detailed and insufficient. I know the beginning of this tale and the end, but I am rather missing the middle. Tell me, what do you know of our world's history? Oh, please. I have no interest in that. Your books are too full of it already. No, I want to know about the celestial. I want to know about your gods. This text tells me that they created all creatures, but nothing of what came before. Where did these gods come from? Who are their people? Where are the others of their kind?
Oh, what's up, Martyr? Yeah, starting over. Yeah, I just started on it maybe a few days ago.
Of course you don't have any useful information. Why did I expect anything else? Now please, run along. I have a world to decipher.
No amount of pestering will get the elf to take his eyes off his book or respond to your questions.
Well, you aren't here on my list. Scrammy, we're trying to catch a killer here.
Back in the day. Been a while, huh?
Ah, there you are. Husband. Would you please tell this very charming gaggle of not at all rat-like babes that I am by no accounts this loser woman, nor do I sing, in fact. I'm deathly, deathly allergic.
And still play pinball here, too, so... Yup. Play some tables that are like way back in the 50s too. 50s and 60s. Even in real life, Captain Fantastic, the one that's got Elton John on it. The bowling alley I very, very rarely go to. It actually has a Ted Nugent table. I'm trying to think what else it had. But yeah, there's like old school pinball tables at that bowling alley. I think all but maybe one of them though cost like $2. Like, a little too expensive for that stuff.
Correct you are, spouse of mine. Madame Josephine Gribbles de P refuses to be confused with anyone else. What? What's so funny?
Her pinched face cracks into a great grin, and she shoos the children away from her with a laugh.
Yeah, okay, you found me out. Go on and git, and maybe I'll sing you something when I'm good and ready.
She turns to you, dark-eyed and dirty-haired, and smiles flatly.
Gotta keep ourselves entertained, haven't we? You presume right. Nope. Trying not to find anything out either. Ignorance is bliss. The utterer, the better.
I'll just take my leave.
Suddenly, her eyes cloud to an unnatural black. Greyish veins run down her face, and her mouth tightens into a cruel sneer. As quickly as they came, the clouds clear. She smiles as though no change came over her.
Good luck, Chief. No!
Gods, didn't your mother teach you any manners?
She got eaten by a void woke.
Save that. Well, she's pickable. No one else around. The problem is I can't get behind her. Oh, shoot, I can't. I forgot. I gotta put a point in thievery first. Fin's empty.
The hatch is blocked. I need to find another way.
Chop, chop. I think there was supposed to have been a book I was able to steal right here. Not unless I already have it. Oh yeah, speaking of that, I am using a mod in this game. This one here, sprint settings. Change your movement speed. Okay, yeah, I think this is the book I stole right here. I'll talk to everybody.
What are you trying to hear anyway?
A broad dwarf sits totally upright on the bench, eyes closed, palms face up on his knees. His beard is a cascade of meticulous plaits, each one braided through with golden medallions. He raises an eyebrow as you approach, but doesn't open his eyes.
Listen up, boy. Hear that? The ship, of course.
A wave of sound washes over you. The unintelligible chatter of your shipmates, the groaning of wood from floor to ceiling, the boom, crash, and crackle of waves around you, complaints from the sea itself.
And? Sick as a leper's cat. From the state of it, I'd say she's being cared for by a bunch of beardless babes who never loved anyone but their own mums.
Yep, and that's a common trope throughout all the RPGs. All the dwarves have Scottish accents.
There's more. Listen close. There now, just like that. Squeak!
His eyes snap open as his countenance breaks into an expression of joy. One great paw claps you on the back, the other catches you before you lose your footing.
There. You heard it, didn't you? I knew it. Aye, this is good news, boy. Good news. It's the wheel. Don't you see, you beautiful idiot? Squeaks whenever the helmsman jerks it clockwise, which means we're heading east. Burn my beard. That means if we've been traveling for, yes, only 10.34 nautical miles to Fort Joy.
Huh? Can't help but think you must have been a ship pilot in a previous life.
Ah, so you've eyes as well as ears, eh? You'll go far, mate. Captain, actually. That figure tells me we're getting close to the joy. Close to what lies beyond it, too.
The dwarf leans back from the table and strokes his beard, gold medallions jingling merrily. His eyes roll over to you.
That'll be all. Thank you kindly, boy.
One of them, a divine order loyal. They killed a sorcerer, you know. They'll hide the evidence.
Gotta hurry back.
Make no mistake.
Oh, excuse me. And I guess since I'm at a good stopping point right now, I'm gonna put my beans back in the fridge real quick. I'll be back. Oh, and also to let everybody know, my cutoff time is probably here. Let me go here. Is probably going to be somewhere between 6:30 to 6:45. I basically have to do all my normal stuff early. It's snowing outside, and it's supposed to get pretty bad by the time late evening nighttime hits, like sometime just before I have to go to work. So because of that, I gotta get everything taken care of early because I gotta leave for work early. I gotta give myself some time to clear the snowbank out of my driveway or whatever. I gotta drive carefully and all that, so I gotta leave for work early. Oh, and I'm gonna go ahead and have one or both of these Reese's peanut butter eggs. Bigger and you never know. No, I actually want to remove it from the hot bar. So I actually have more than one hot bar. Okay.
Thank you.
you put a knuckle in it? I'm trying to concentrate.
Yep. Gotta attack a mattress.
To register, sir. Good. You faring okay, so glad to hear it. You head on in now.
Standing at the center of the room, you spot a sorcerer haughtily eyeing a pair of nervous-looking magisters. They keep their crossbow trained upon her as she's being interrogated by an officer.
So you admit it then? You murdered that poor fella?
Yes, I did. But of course, that was only the beginning.
She turns her head and looks you straight in the eye.
There are others whose lives must end.
Good God, the woman's mad. You there, sorcerer, go and fetch Magister Siwan. We need to do more to collar this maniac. We need to shackle her. Hands and feet.
It means your journey draws to a close. Do stick around for its finale, though, because...
She reaches for her collar and simply removes it.
I'm just about to create a scene.
Subdue her, man, quickly! If she casts source, the Voidwalker will come. They'll end us all.
She smiles with wicked satisfaction.
Precisely.
Y'all exploded.
What happened?
Don't really care for that. I guess I can make something. Don't know what though. Sharp piece of metal. Still burning. There we go. Joe's hungry. Oh wait, that's crafting. I forgot how to do it. Nope, didn't work. Wanted to try to put my, try to put some of these items in the crate here. Crate or maybe backpack. How to do it. I'm gonna have to go on the browser for this. Okay. Bit unintuitive, but nope. Still not explaining it. No, it's saying swap items. Yeah, that... kind of counterintuitive. You would have thought that, just by simply opening that, and then just go ahead and, while that's open, then start selecting items from the inventory and putting them in there, but no, apparently it don't work like that. Put that one in the hot, put that one in the hot bar. Probably not ever gonna use that. And also, if I'm understanding the way armor works in this game, there, it basically acts as additional hit points, but at the same time, it also resists, physical or magical ailments. Like, as long as you got some armor up, the ailments won't affect you. It's only when you have zero of that particular armor is when the affliction will actually hit you. Wait a minute, Buckethead! Whoops. Lumpy giblets.
Ah.
The young woman lies in a heap on the floor. She's breathing normally, but her eyes are wide open, like those of a corpse. Dark, grayish-black clouds swirl through them.
Permanent. Go up there just yet.
The Magister lies on the floor, unconscious and bleeding from a dire-looking wound.
Too much to carry. Where's that thing away? I got everything.
The hatch is blocked. I need to find another way.
No, not the final dark. Not yet.
It's no use. Your word.
The dice roll darkly. They're rolling for me.
Ifan lies motionless, curled on the ground like an animal. Under his shaggy hair, you can see green eyes fluttering as if in a nightmare. Below, his eyes flicker open, but he doesn't register.
Lucian. Lucian.
Ifan cries out, then his eyes fall closed again. No matter. The lizard's eyes close as he slips into a... The dwarf lies in a heap on the floor, his great beard twisted and tangled around him. He is stock still. You can't see if he's... You hear a faint thud, thud, thud.
I would have thought that, this darn dorky would have been enough to unlock it. Let me try to unlock it from the other side then. Okay, let me go back downstairs. I think it was over here. Loot the sheep. Man, I don't think you can get over there. Don't get it. Let me up. Go back on the browser. Okay, apparently I've already used it. Supposed to be a bunch of recipes I could learn in here too. Yeah, I'm back on the browser. Yeah, there's also supposed to be a bunch of recipes I can learn in here too. Again, there are supposed to be some recipes I can learn in here too. There we go. Here's my recipes. It's gotta be a boiling pot. Well, good to know. Alright, we're gonna continue on with the story. And then I think once I land in Camp Joy and get unlocked the waypoint, I'm gonna call it good. Excuse me.
Through the door and are suddenly face to face with an undead. His skull is bizarrely angular and a glorious jewel sits in the middle of his forehead. The skeleton is quickly leafing through a volume of Cranley Hubert's famous encyclopedia, muttering to himself.
No, no, no! What damn fools record knowledge on a pulped tree? It catches fire, it turns into must when wet, it cannot even resist acid. No wonder they're so bloody ignorant.
The skeleton looks up and notices you for the first time.
And the guy's a skeleton, so he really shouldn't be talking like this. I mean, doesn't have a voice box, doesn't have a larynx or anything. You know, doesn't have a tongue, doesn't have any mouth muscles. You know, maybe if the game would have said something like telepathically, he speaks to you, then on with the convo. But no, they don't do that here.
The skeleton groans and looks back to his book, frantically flipping from page to page.
Yes, indeed. It's the look of someone that wants to read the bloody book he's holding. Now, if you're really quite finished, I believe you have lifeboats to flee to. Please, I was no more an elf than you are those rags you're wearing. I had a mask, rather ingeniously designed, which allowed me to take that primitive form. A mask that was stolen by that damned witch after her little scene.
Damn, must be one powerful witch. Can, like, blow up an entire ship and then still have a little bit of time to steal books or steal masks from people. Wonder if she can play the accordion too.
Still, she'll drown with the rest of these fools, and I will simply pluck my mask from her cold, dead hands.
The skeleton holds up his book in one quick, frustrated movement.
I am trying to discover if there is anyone worth saving, and I'll be damned if I let the lives of some mayflies get in my way. Go on, go. Swim or drown or do whatever takes your fancy. I have a book to read.
Damn, he's a bookworm to the bitter end.
Was painted recently, judging from its pungent scent. You don't recognize. You press your palm against the door to open it. The wood feels neither cold nor warm, but simply gray. The color drains from your hand, and you are left numb. It doesn't budge. The door groans open, but an
Gotcha, nothing else. Oh yeah, I forgot about this. Final Fantasy 14 does it too. Instead of saying, God damn it, they say, God's damn it. No. Forgot how to cancel that. I got everything. Now I gotta go find this boat. And apparently I don't have the key for it. That's right, there's gonna be a battle here. No, out of range apparently. One stinking health point.
Yanks at one of the nearby ropes to no avail.
You said there were other people down there. We need to help them.
You see those tentacles, kid? It's time to get the hell out of here.
I've already been down there. And this time around, I think I did talk to everybody. And not to mention, I really don't have time for this. So I'm going to risk having everybody on the island call me selfish, because apparently they were all survivors, despite the fact that even though I talked to them, they all just kind of go. Let me try this then. So the ladder's no longer blocked. Ooh.
That's what you big mouth, didn't you?
A little closer.
Never need. Wait. Where are the rest? You're going to get them, right?
Oh, I think I just screwed myself.
The Magister lies on the floor.
Dude, nobody is moving. Really? So guess what I get to do? Thank you. Actually, no. I need to do a regular save. Alrighty, well, that's gonna do it for me. I'm gonna go ahead and shut it down. Like I said, it's snowing out. Weather's supposed to be pretty crappy. So I'm gonna need to be able to leave for work early, which means I need to get all my daily stuff done early. So, it's about a good time to shut down as any. But aside from that, though, hey, thanks for dropping in and hanging out with me, everybody. And I'm liking what I'm playing so far. So there's that as well. And I should be on roughly the same time tomorrow, like 4:30 p.m. and that's U.S. Central Time, and in all likelihood it's gonna be this game again. But until then though, thanks again for coming, everybody, and see you all next time.